Hi, this is Deborah with LegalOfficeGuru.com, and today I'm going to show you how to create a shortcut key for your most frequently used special characters and symbols. First, we're going to start on the Insert tab and go over here to the extreme right and click on Symbol. You notice we're starting off using the same method we would for inserting a symbol via the ribbon. Here, though, once we select the symbol, we want to tell Microsoft Word what shortcut key we want to use in the future to insert the same symbol without using the mouse. As we click on Symbol, we're going to click on More Symbols to go into the dialog box. Now, I will tell you that I often get a little frustrated trying to find the symbol I'm looking for. That's what makes this special Characters tab so convenient. A lot of the most frequently used symbols are located here. If you can find the symbol you're looking for on the Special Characters tab, that's good news. Otherwise, go back to the Symbols tab and drop down the subset list to make searching a little easier. Regardless of where you find the character you're looking for, your next step will be to click on the shortcut key. Before we do that, though, let's look to the right here. And if there's already a shortcut key assigned to that particular symbol, it will be listed here. If that was okay with you, just make a note of that and use that shortcut key in the future. If there's nothing here or you want to change it, though, click on the shortcut key to get to the Customize Keyboard dialog box. Click your cursor into the Press New Shortcut Key field, and then press the shortcut key of your choice. Shortcut keys are generally combinations of Shift and or Alt and or Control plus a letter or number on your keyboard. To use a shortcut key, you would hold down the particular combination of Shift and or Alt and or Control, then click the letter or number that goes with it. So now that our focus is in the Press New Shortcut Key field, I'm going to press Control Shift S to make that the shortcut key for the section symbol. If that particular shortcut key is already used by Microsoft Word for another command, you'll see it listed underneath next to the phrase currently assigned to. Don't worry, you can still use that combination, but Microsoft Word wants you to be aware that you'll be overriding a current shortcut key assignment. If that particular command is not something you care to have quick access to, go ahead and click the Assign button, and then click Close. When you get back to the Symbol dialog box, you'll see the shortcut key you assigned to that symbol listed near the bottom. Click Close to go back to your document. Go ahead and test your new shortcut key out. I'm going to click Control Shift S, and voila, a section symbol appears. While all this is still fresh, you might want to set up shortcut keys for more of your frequently used symbols. Then take a moment to write down your new shortcut keys on a sticky note to attach to your computer monitor. It probably won't be long before you'll be able to throw that sticky note away, though, because you'll have memorized all your shortcut keys and will be happily typing away, never having to touch your mouse to insert those symbols ever again. This has been Deborah with LegalOfficeGuru.com. Thanks for watching.